Hi, I'm Angela Lee Smith. I teach Korean language at the East Asian Languages and Literature Department. So today, the summary of my presentation is, how do I go to the next slide? Sorry. So I implemented audio portfolios for my students. And these portfolios are perfect examples of progress and evidence-based approach. And I use Canvas tool, audio video submission, and it is totally free just for you. Okay. So why portfolios? Because we oftentimes face great challenges to ensure every student's progress and achieve something after the semester. And then, so we need some kind of instructional tools to identify how to adjust pedagogical strategies. And then, as you all know, we have a slogan that no child left behind, and that applies even in this higher education environment. So as I said, portfolios allows me to practice progress and evidence-based teaching practice and makes it learning as a continued and ongoing process. So as you see here, this is the example of the elementary Korean course site. And I assigned 4 portfolio assignments. So every 2 weeks, students record their speaking on the given topics and then they just submit. And this is the instructor's side. And you see students have 2 choices. They can either submit audio files or video files. But some students prefer video files, so you get to see their messy dorm room background. And then once they submit their speaking file, I get to listen to their file and analyze, and then immediately provide my feedback. And so this one, I can either type or I can even upload my speaking. So especially for elementary language course, the pronunciation is very critical. So that really helps. So Canvas built-in audio video submission tool really allows me to use my students' performance data to check their progress and then help me make more informed instructional decisions. And I can monitor my students very closely and provide them with frequent feedback. So it's totally stress-free and worth it, and let's utilize it more. That's it. Any questions? Like, sales pitch for Canvas. And then you get 24/7 non-stop support. Yes.
Yes. Did you have students complain about the interface at all, or did you have to help students with it?
Not at all. This is very easy. They get to see the button, either audio recording or video. So click, record, and then submit button. That's it. Yeah. Yes.
And you mentioned that it's stress-free.
Yes.
But so I don't know how many students you have in your class. But
30. All 3 sections.
So it must be a stress for you to give each one a feedback. Do you record audio files to feedback?
Only for the necessary cases, yes. But I listen every single one, right, every 2 weeks. And it's not stress. At all. Yes.
You give feedback to everybody.
Yes.
You do give feedback?
I give every single one feedback, yes. Even though it's not good, I say good, but. Yeah. Yeah. So it's a very rewarding experience, both to me and students. So at the end of semester, students get to listen to them from day one file to date, look, end of the file, and then it, they can clearly listen and see how they improved. So it's really rewarding experience. Yes.
Actually, somewhat connected to that. So you said these are restricted to you. Is there a way to have them so the students could see each other to do some sort of peer evaluations?
That's only for the one-on-one tutorial session with the TAs. So TA get to listen to each file, and then they share. And then only every 2 weeks, we get to have the session, a clinic time. So we get to pick some files I would like to get students' attention, and then we practice together. Yeah.
Okay, so you have to pick which ones the other students can see.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Yes.
I think it is possible in Canvas to have a peer evaluation type of assignment,
mm-hmm.
but you might not want to do that at the 101.
Yeah, I don't use the function because the students usually even very hard to listen to their own voice, mm-hmm. so they say no. So we just get together and then go through together. Yeah.
Some of my students had a technical problem when they are recording themselves,
mm-hmm.
and I ask them to ask Canvas people,
mm-hmm.
not me, right? And then I don't know if you have any problem like that.
Before using Canvas, I had the same problem because the students use their phone in trying to upload their file, but they use laptop, and they use the Canvas tool,
yeah,
then they don't have to upload
right,
anything.
Right.
They
couldn't record on the screen.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what's the problem, and the Canvas people said that they are trying to figure out the problem. I'm wondering if that being fixed.
As far as I know, we did testing and we couldn't find any issues ourselves, so it might be configurations on their own laptops or machines that they're using. But we'd be happy to have them bring in their laptops and have us look at it, but the system seems to be working for other students, so it must be specific to whatever configurations on their machines.
So,
so
if they have problems, just go to Timberly.
Yes.
Jen.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.